Extraction of metals of high reactivity. Metals of high reactivity are sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium and aluminium, etc. Metals of high reactivity can be extracted from its combined form by electrolysis of molten ore. Extraction of sodium. Occurrence. Sodium can be obtained from sodium chloride by electrolytic reduction of molten sodium chloride. Electrolytic reduction. During electrolysis, sodium is deposited at cathode and chlorine is liberated at anode. That is, at cathode, Na plus E minus gives Na. At anode, 2Cl minus gives Cl2 plus 2E minus. Extraction of aluminium. Occurrence. Aluminium being reactive metal occur in combined form, that is, in the form of bauxite. Bauxite ore contains 30-70% Al2O3 and remaining portion contain gangue made of sand, silica and iron oxide. Extraction of aluminium takes place in two steps. Step 1. Concentration of ore. The process of removing impurities from the ore is called concentration of ore. Impurities from bauxite ore is removed by Bayer's process. Bayer's process. Ore containing impurities are crushed and then fed to digester tank. In digester, it is treated with hot concentrated sodium hydroxide solution under high pressure and at 140 degree Celsius to 150 degree Celsius for 2 to 8 hours. In the digester, aluminium oxide reacts with sodium hydroxide to form sodium aluminate. That is, Al2O3 plus 2NaOH gives 2NaAlO2 plus H2O. Sodium aluminate then mixed with water and then cooled to 50 degree Celsius gives aluminium hydroxide in precipitate form. That is, NaAlO2 plus H2O gives NaOH plus AlOH3. This precipitate is filtered, washed, dried and heated at 1000 degree Celsius to get alumina. That is, AlOH3 gives Al2O3 plus 3H2O. From the digester, iron oxide impurity can be removed by filtration as it did not dissolve in aqueous sodium hydroxide. However, silica dissolves in sodium hydroxide and forms water-soluble sodium silicate. Step 2. Electrolytic reduction of alumina. Alumina reach its molten state when heated above temperature of 2000 degrees Celsius. To reduce its melting point, cryolite and fluorspar are added. Molten alumina is fed to steel tank which lined inside with carbon which act as cathode. Similarly, a set of carbon rods is dipped in the molten alumina which acts as anode. During electrolysis, oxygen is liberated at anode and aluminium is formed at cathode. That is, at anode, 2O2- gives O2 plus 4E-. At cathode, Al3+ plus 3E- gives Al. Aluminium sinks to the bottom of the tank and can be removed periodically. The oxygen reacts with carbon to form carbon dioxide. Since anode gets oxidized, hence its quantity reduces over time. Hence, it has to be replaced from time to time.